गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स वी वर डूइंग चैप्टर 5 क्रिएटिंग वेब पेजेस यूजिंग HTML. इट्स अ वेरी बिग चैप्टर. वी हैव ऑलरेडी कवर्ड आई थिंक 7-8 वीडियोस. नाउ टुडे इट विल बी द लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर. नाउ वी विल बी कवरिंग टुडे इमेज टैग एंड हाइपरलिंक टैग. सो बिफोर मूविंग टू द टुडेज टॉपिक वी विल हैव अ क्विक रीकैप ऑफ ऑल द थिंग्स दैट वी हैव डन. Then we will do today's topic. Now, first of all, we did structure of HTML document. A structure of HTML document is somewhat like this: HTML, head, title, body. Then, how do we implement the code? So, first we write the code in the text editor. Then, after writing the code in the text editor, we can view it in the browser. Browser could be Internet Explorer, Mozilla, Firefox. Any one of them could be the browser. Now, next is we did some attributes of body tag. Attributes of body tag are BG color, text, background, top margin, left margin, bottom margin, right margin. These all are attributes of body tag which are given with the body tag. Then break line tag we did. Break line tag is used to insert an line. It's an empty tag. Then we did header tag. There are 6 header tags, H1 to S6. H1 is the highest level of heading, S6 is the lowest level of heading. Then paragraph tag, it is used to insert a blank line after and before the after the text, enclosed between these two tags, and it's a container tag. It has opening as well as closing tag. Then this horizontal rule tag is used to insert a horizontal line. Then font tag is used to change the font style, font color and font size. Then this marquee displays a scrolling text message. You can place moving or scrolling text in your web page using marquee tag. Marquee tag is also having some attributes. Attributes of marquee tag are scroll amount, then behavior, direction, BG color, width, height. Then we did list tag. List tag make your web page more readable and attractive. There are two kinds of list tag: ordered list and unordered list. Ordered list is having numbering like 1, 2, 3, ABCD, or it could be in Roman numbers too. And unordered list is a numbered list which is having bullet sign. There are 3 types of bullet signs on this. Those are square, circle and disc. After list tag we did table tag. Table tag is used to create a list. Now in table tag there are some attributes that we use with the table tag only, that is border, border color, background color, BG color which is width, alignment, cell padding, cell spacing. Then attributes of table tag in TR and TD. Now TR stands for table row, TD stands for table data. So these are the attributes of TR and TD tag. This border color, BG color, height. Earlier we studied border color for table. Now it's for row or column. Okay. So this way we can set this attribute also. Then these are also attributes of TR and TD tag. Align, V align stands for vertical align, call span, row span. This we did in the previous class. Okay, call span extend the cells horizontally and row span extend the cells vertically. Okay, after that today now we are starting with this image tag. Now what is image tag? You can use image tag or pictures in web page. It's an empty tag. So how do we give this tag? We have to use the src attribute with this. So this is the syntax which you can see on the page: img src equals to path of image. Okay, suppose there is a image mercury.jpg on D drive, then this is the path of that image and it has been given in img src. I'll show you on notepad like how to give the code and then how to see it in the browser view. But before that you do understand the theoretical concept. Okay. Now alt. Alt is alternative text. It specifies the text to be displayed if the image is not present or browser cannot display image. Means if image is not coming somehow, browser is not able to display the image that you have inserted through IMG SRC code, then that alternative text will come. Okay, and that alternative text will show like what is over there. Okay. Like you can write the detail about that image in that alternative text. Okay. Now, next, align. It specifies the alignment of the image with respect to the text around it. There are 5 types of alignment: top, bottom, left, right, middle. So we will see how we can align after inserting a image. Then in this height also we can specify for the image. What will be the syntax or the code for specifying height? IMG SRC equals to address of image, then height equals to 50%. 50% this percentage is in proportion to the screen. Then similarly we can specify the width. Width is also like it's in proportion to the screen only. So IMG SRC equals to image, then the proportion of that image. Then border, it specifies the thickness of the border for the image. So in this we a complete path of image file is given, then we specify the border and its value. Suppose you want to give 5 border, then we will give 5 over here. Now this is an example of code which is given in your book also. You can read that code and you can try to understand that its accordance to this Mercury image only. Now I will show you how to use this IMG tag in our own code. Okay, so for that where we are coming to the HTML text editor, which is Notepad. So before opening Notepad, there are many windows which are open. I am just closing those windows. Okay, these windows I opened just to prepare that text for you. Okay, now here this is our page on which we were working. So first I have opened it into the browser view. We will see what was there on that page. So this was our page till table we have done, cell spacing, cell padding, till that part we have done. So now we will do today's task, which is image insertion and hyperlink. Okay, so before doing that, I want that today's things I want after a line. These are just pop-ups coming since my net is on. Okay, so here I'll draw a horizontal rule first. I'll give a tag for that and then we will do today's task. Okay, so let's start with that. For doing so, I have to come into the code window. So code, where is code? It's in the Notepad file. So we have to open the code for this by doing open with Notepad. Okay, now this file is open over here. Okay, simply we will come at the last after the table. Here this table is done. So after table, now today first I am entering a HR tag. Okay, why I am entering HR? With size equals to 5, I have entered this and I am giving date also over there. Today is like any date. Suppose I am giving 6 August, this date I am giving. So let's see the changes in the browser view first. I have saved it. I will come to the browser window, F5. See, this line has come and 6 August it has come. Now here onwards we will do our tags, which is image tag and hyperlink. So first we are going to do the image tag. For doing image tag, what is the code? What code we have studied? Here is the code for image tag. It's written over here. INGSRC equals to path of picture. So we will write that here in code IMGSRC. SRC is source, image ka source kya hai, theek hai. Now we will take the address. First we will find a picture where we are having most probably in my pictures computer. Here pictures, sample pictures are there. So many pictures are there. Suppose I want to insert this koala. So I'll see the path. Now what is the procedure for seeing path? I'll do right click on this. After doing right click, I'll go on the properties. In properties, here path is shown, location or path is shown, and we will see what kind of image is this. This is .jpg or jpg image. So we will copy the path. We will click over here, drag the mouse, and we will copy this path. Okay, I have copied this path by pressing Ctrl C. Now I know the name also, it's koala.jpg. Now I'll come to the code here. I'll simply paste it. I have pasted the address, okay, so that I don't have to type it. Now here the complete address will be when you will write the name of picture also, which is koala, koala. This was the name of picture .jpg. Okay, so now we will close this, and we will close this too. Okay, Control S. I have saved it. By pressing Control S again, I can show you it here also. Now where we will go in the browser view. Browser view is there. I have opened this browser view. Now I'll do F5, refresh. See, as soon as I pressed F5, this picture has come, and it has come in such a big size. Okay, since I didn't specify any width, height, I didn't specify, so it has come in this much size. Okay, now what I will do, I will try to adjust the height and width of this image. So how to adjust that height and width of this image? So for doing that, what we will go again to the code. We know already that if we want to align, we will do later, align and alt. Before that, first we will adjust the height and width, because it's not letting us see other things. So first we will adjust the height and width of this image. Okay, here it's 50%. Let's make it, suppose height I'm making here, it's height equals to, let's say 50% only. Let's see how much is that. Okay, see here F5. See, as soon as I did height 50%, it has become like this. Now I will change the width also. Okay, so for that we are coming to the code again. Here now I will write width. Width equals to 50%. Let's see. Okay, save the changes. Come to the browser view. Here do F5. See, width has been decreased. Width and height both are 50% now, and you can see the image. Okay, now we will do the alignment also. Okay, so for that also, where we have to come, we have to come this code. So for setting alignment, here alignment, so this address is quite big. I'll write here after picture we have to set alignment also. Align equals to, I am doing right, GN equals to R-I-G-S-T. Right. Save the changes. Come to the browser view. Press F5. See. As soon as I did alignment right, what has happened? It has shifted to the right side. Now this picture is coming in right side. This image is coming in right side. Okay. So we can similarly, we can shift it to left side, we can shift it to the top, we can shift it to the middle. These are the options in this, like in align. Options are, let's have a look on the options. It's top, bottom, left, right, or middle. So whatever value we will specify in this align, this image will behave in that manner only. If I'll give bottom, it will come in bottom. So let's try bottom once. What is bottom? Align equals to, we will do bottom. Okay. After writing bottom, save the changes. Come to the browser view. Here in browser view, press F5. See, this is bottom as well as middle also. Bottom means bottom of the page. Okay. So this way we can set these attributes of image. Now one attribute is left, which is alt. So we will do that also. So here only I will specify alt attribute. See, if you noticed on the screen, this 6th August and this image, they are coming on the same line. So what we can do here, we can give one BR tag so that this picture come into the next line. Just have a look, save the changes, come to the browser view, do F5. Okay, more BR tags we can give in that. One more BR, two BRs now we have given. Let's see what is the effect. Okay, now two line gap has come. After 6 August, I give two BR tag means two line gap has been inserted, then this picture is coming. Now we will do the alt attribute of this IMG SRC tab. Now what was the alt attribute? Inside alt attribute, what we write? We write the text. So text, I want to write Koala. Okay, so I'll write that only. Here I'll write here I have to come after width. Okay, bottom, and here I will write alt text equals to Koala. Okay, PLA. Now save the changes. Come on the browser window. Here do F5 refresh. Okay, so since picture is visible, so when picture will not be visible, then that alt text will be in use. Like if this Explorer is not working, or there is some issue that picture is not able to appear here, then Koala will be coming over here. That is the alternative text. That is the use of that alt attribute of this alt attribute of image tag. Okay, now we are moving to the hyperlink. So what is the code for hyperlink? Hyperlink, what is hyperlink first of all? Hyperlinks are the links in a web page which on clicking take you to some other location of website or web page. So a link is a pointer from one page to other page. This linking can be of two types, external linking or internal linking. Now in external linking means when you are connecting one page to another page. And internal linking when the connection is on the same page, like you are connecting the top of that page to the bottom of the page. Okay, so here to add a hyperlink, anchor tag is used, which is denoted by capital A. And what is the code for that? What is the code? We will have a look at the code also. See, code here you can see href. Code for link is, for hyperlinking is href. And complete code we write in this way: a href equals to address of destination page, or address of the page that we want to connect. Okay, so now we will do this. For doing this, where we have to come, we have to come to the Excel part only, sorry, for this notepad only. Here I'll do the code. Okay, so before this image only, I would like to insert a hyperlink. Okay, here I would like to insert a hyperlink, so I am writing the code for that: a href equals to, now address we will write of the page. Now see, you can see this is my page, list page. This is list page that we opened. I'll show you on the desktop. See, this is list page on which we are working, and there is one more page, my page too, that also we created earlier in the first or second video. So now what I will do, I'll connect this list page to this my page too by hyperlink. Now before doing so, I'll just have a look what is there on my page too. See, this is on my page too. On my page too, there is HTML is very interesting language. It is written in class 7 is written. Now I am closing it in front of you. I have closed it. Now simply what will I do? I'll right click on it. I'll go to properties and I'll copy the address of this page. Okay. So address, from here I can copy the way I copied the address of image. So control C. I can do, then I'll come to the notepad. Here I'll paste that address, and I have to write the name also of the page. So name of the page was, let's have a look again. I forgot the name of the page. I think my page 2 it was. Yes, my page 2. So we can also copy this from here. Okay, I have copied name also. And what will be the extension this time? Extension will be HTML, because it's a HTML page. Okay, so I have written the name of page. Now HTML I have written. I'll close this, and before that we have to close this too. Okay, now save changes by pressing save or control S. Now we will come here. One thing we forgot. That is, like, what will be shown over there, like on which text I will, I'm writing here link only. Okay, so let's, now we will open it in the browser view. I have closed this browser view. It is not open over there, so I have to close. I'll open it. Okay, this is our browser view. Right now nothing is visible. I'll do F5 to refresh. F5 I did. Nothing has come. So we will open the source again to check. How to open the source? We do right click, then open with notepad. We will do right click, then open with notepad. Okay, now here this code has come that we were writing. Now I did that, where I wrote the code, ahref. Yes, now one mistake we have done. What is that? there any mistake that we have done. Isn't it? There is no mistake as such. Yes, this is a thing. Okay. Here I'll write link. Then I'll close this A tag. I forgot to close this. Okay. Now save. This is the syntax. You have to write A, href, address of the page, then text which will be displayed over there on which you will click to go to the link part. So I have written here link. I can write link to my page 2. My page 2. Okay. And then we have to close this anchor tag. We will save the changes. Now we will open this. Here we will do refresh. Refresh we have done. Let's see whether that link. Yes, here you can see the link. Link to my page 2 at bottom. Okay. Now if when I will click on this, it's a hyperlink. Hyperlink has been created. When I'm moving, see, when I'm moving this pointer, a tooltip text. This is called tooltip text. A tooltip text is coming, which is showing the address of the file which is connected to this. So I'll do click on this. See, I did click, and where I reached, I reached on that page. Though I closed that page, see, again I'm closing it in front of you. It is not open. Okay, now I am simply opening my that page. That has been closed by mistake. Yes, this page I have opened. Now I will click only link on the link, and that page will be, that link page will be opened. See, I did click, I have reached. Okay, why that page also got closed? Because I closed this, and that page is related to my page. Now we will do back from here. We can go back to our page. If we go forward, we will come on that page. If we'll do backward, we will come on this page. So this is our main page or page that we were creating. Now this is a hyperlink on that web page, and by clicking on that hyperlink, we are going to the next page that we have connected with it. So this way we can create our own website. Okay, all of you just try it. Like, you create your own website, you create your own home page, then connect that home page with other pages. Try to do that and send it to me on WhatsApp group. Okay, students, this is all for today. This chapter is over now. Okay, so next things we'll do in the, first we will do the question answers of this chapter in the next class, then we will move ahead. This is all for today. Thank you.